Next on Channel 2 News, dancing in the streets in Dallas, celebrating a Super Bowl championship.
And folks in Houston also joined the party. Good evening, I'm Larry Onis.
And I'm Sherman Chow. The governor watches the game with the president, and students send a message to legislators in Austin. 2 News is next.
Why would anyone stay in a place where the night lasts for 6 months?
Come on!
Let me show you where it's at.
Come on!
Let me show you where it's at.
Come on!
Let me show you where it's at.
Hey, Jay.
Got a couple of cold ones?
Hey, guys. It's the Arctic.
Cold Miller Lite. I like it like that.
Great taste and less filling beer is pretty important, especially when you have a long evening in front of you.
Working nights is gonna kill me.
Miller Lite. It's everything you want a beer to be.
Ask anyone who's driven a Ford lately. Ask them why Taurus is the best-selling car in America. Why F-Series is the best-selling truck in America. In fact, ask them why 5 of the 10 best-selling cars and trucks in America are Fords. Ask and they'll tell you. Quality breeds success. Have you driven a Ford lately? It's more than just a question. It's an answer.
Genuine draft. The world's a very cool place.
Next Sunday, heart pounding video. You're hang gliding 1 mile above the earth. Suddenly something goes wrong. You're plummeting out of control. Then out scuba diving went from out of nowhere a school of man-eating sharks attack. Video so extraordinary you can only see it on an all-new Eyewitness Video, NBC next Sunday.
Barry Levinson's homicide on NBC Wednesday.
Why did you buy a Ford truck?
Because they took the Ranger and made it even better. Ford totally redesigned it from the ground up. More aerodynamic, bigger tires. It's hot. No wonder it's the best-selling compact truck in Texas.
Why did you buy a Ford truck?
Because Ford makes a truck for Texas with the features and value that I demand. I got this pickup with air-conditioned and automatic transmission at no extra charge. Now that adds up to a deal I couldn't beat.
Channel 2, KPRC-TV, Houston's 24-hour news channel. Now, Channel 2 News with Sherman Chow, Larry Ortis, Ted Shaw, and Craig Roberts with Sports Sunday.
Big party in Big D tonight, and you know why. The Dallas Cowboys take the hide right off the Buffalo Bills. Groan, grin, and get used to it if you're an Oilers fan. The other Texas team is a Super Bowl champ.
As you saw on Channel 2, the Dallas Cowboys herded the Buffalo Bills out of the Rose Bowl 52-17. They have a Super Bowl trophy and Texas-sized bragging rights. Brian Myler live from the celebration now in Dallas. Brian?
Good evening from downtown Dallas. And I tell you what, this is the place to be after this Super Bowl because these fans here are going crazy. They have been gathering here in the streets ever since the Super Bowl. Cowboys went on to victory tonight, and right now they are filling the streets here. To say there is dancing in the streets of downtown Dallas would be an understatement. There is dancing, there is singing, there are banners, balloons, and even some folks who are selling Super Bowl victory t-shirts already. We are in the West End Marketplace of downtown Dallas, not too far from the historic school book depository. And I tell you what, these fans are really relishing this Super Bowl victory. It has been 14 years since the Dallas Cowboys went to a Super Bowl, and right now they are celebrating this, and they're celebrated today by scoring at least 3 points for every year they were absent from the Super Bowl. And I tell you what, these fans are going to be a little bit bleary-eyed on Monday morning reporting for work, but they say that they deserve it. They say it's been a long time and the boys are back. We're hearing once again that phrase we've heard in the past. Super Bowl Cowboys are America's team. And to tell you how this celebration has gotten out of hand here, even police cars are being inscribed with Cowboy slogans by the fans here. That is the scene here in downtown Dallas. The celebration will continue for a few hours, I'm sure. I'm Brian Mylar, reporting for NBC News in downtown Dallas. Back to you.
Thanks, Brian. Probably the one night nobody will get a ticket for that.
No kid. Boy, most Cowboy fans love that stuff. Next best thing, though, to being there, plopping down right in front of the TV set.
Millions of football fans grabbed the chips and dips and watched all the action. They probably enjoyed a better view than those actually in Pasadena, or so says our Maria Valdez.
No lack of enthusiasm, that's for sure, as folks jam sports bars across the city tonight at the granddaddy of the sports bars, Griff's in Montrose, where a decidedly Dallas crowd took special pleasure in tonight's trouncing. Payback, they say, for the team that humiliated the Oilers. Now, there were some Buffalo fans here, all one table of them.
I hate to tell you guys, but you're kind of outnumbered here.
That's okay. We're not worried about it. It's no problem. We know Buffalo's going to win.
Oiler fans? Well, you had to look hard to find them. In fact, owner Mike Griffin offered 75-cent discounts on beer to anyone wearing Oiler blue.
They really must be hurt. I mean, I thought the loyal, because there's so many loyal, good Oiler fans, but you're right. We had the cheapest beer we've ever had in 10 years, and it's about, out of 200-300 people here, it's only 10 people have anything blue on.
Okay.
Standing room only on the north side was just that, packed with over 600 folks eating and drinking, all in the name of Super Bowl Sunday. And just when you think you've had enough of all this Super Bowl hype, imagine this. In the time it took us to air this story, had this been commercial time, we would have had to have paid the network over $2.5 million. Each commercial during the Super Bowl sold for over $800,000 for 30 seconds. Maria Valdez, Channel 2 News.
Now, worth every second. Spencer Tillman is in Pasadena, though, and he'll be bringing us a live report on Sports Sunday, and Craig will wrap up the rest of the action coming up.
Well, Sunday is not so super if you're on the receiving end of unnecessary roughness. Wife beating said to be a real problem on Super Bowl Sunday. The Women's Action Coalition is using this game day to pound out that message. Alcohol, stress, high-dollar bets push some men way out of bounds.
The flyers that we're passing out, some of the other things we have done, will help inform women who need the help where the help is.
And that help is available at a number of shelters in Houston today. They had that protest, and they carried that out in front of several sports clubs. By the way, the FBI says a woman is beaten every 15 seconds in this country.
Shoppers at a popular Southwest Side flea market got more than they bargained for today. Gunfire scattered the crowded market about 3:30. Some juveniles had been arguing just before the bullets flew. One boy was shot in the side and is now at Mentob Hospital. No word on any suspects. Houston police were called to this house twice today, first to quiet down some music about 1:30 a.m., the second time just before noon to investigate a murder. A 29-year-old man had been beaten to death, apparently with a tire iron. Beer bottles littered the near downtown home. Authorities believe some kind of argument triggered the fight. Police are now looking for the dead man's roommates.
Midnight looked like strike time for oil and petrochemical workers, but hold on, they're still on the job. A contract for the Oil, Chemical, and Atomic Workers Union runs out tonight, but the head union man says there is progress on a contract, so no strike for now while that union negotiates with the oil and chemical companies.
Well, if you were hurt by last November's tornadoes and live in Harris County, you've got until Tuesday to apply for disaster assistance. The storm ravaged neighborhoods from West Harris County to Channelview. Former President Bush declared the areas a disaster in December. That makes home and business owners eligible for federal aid to rebuild. If you still haven't applied, there's a toll-free number to call for assistance. It's 1-800-462-2029. That deadline again on Tuesday.
Well, some 300 parents plan a not-so-friendly visit to Austin this week. They will apply the pressure to legislators already under the gun to come up with some kind of school funding plan. Del Iglesias says those moms and dad will get support from their kids.
High school kids won't graduate. Kindergarten can't count to eight.
They may only be fourth graders, but these students understand what's at stake if schools close June 1st.
My little brother's going to kindergarten next year, and if we don't have schools next year, then my brother won't even get a proper education.
I care a lot, so that's why I'm doing all this.
They're writing letters to lawmakers and painting posters for their parents' trip to Austin Tuesday morning.
I have three kids in the public schools, and I'm going to Austin because I'm concerned about their education.
Donna Gilger will join her friend and at least 250 other Houston parents on a trip to Austin Tuesday. They don't want schools to close June 1st simply because lawmakers can't come up with the school funding plan. They also joined hundreds of other parents at four town meetings last month. Everyone had their say about school property taxes, equal funding for schools, and political foot-dragging by state legislators. Nancy Lomax says they plan a showdown with lawmakers.
We want our legislators to know that we're watching, and we'll be there as long as it takes until a good education bill is passed.
Five busloads of parents will make the trip to Austin. They plan to confront lawmakers bright and early Tuesday morning. Del Iglesias, Channel 2 News.
And Del says another 100 people will drive to Austin on their own for Tuesday's face-off. It's a great day for the Good Samaritan Home, a place that meets the needs of those who are mentally retarded. That costs money. And so today, a huge crowd turns out for a fundraising dinner. Some 5,000 people dig deep to raise money, and then they kind of dig in. Aside from all the food there, they also open a thrift shop and sell crafts and some home goods, and all that pays off. They raised $4,200 today for those who are mentally retarded. Good project there.
Still ahead, Governor Ann Richards is having dinner with the president.
Yeah, we'll tell you why. She also drafted Mr. Clinton for America's team today. More than 100 people dead after a train wreck. That story next to Nightfall.
But first, here's Ted with a quick look at the forecast.
Well, I'll tell you, I hope everybody got out and enjoyed the sunshine this weekend, because we may not see much more of it in the days ahead. The weather in a few minutes.
Tonight's Channel 2 News is brought to you in part by Crown Services.
Do you have a plumbing problem? Call 777-7777. Do you have an air conditioning problem? Call 777-7777. Do you have an electrical problem? Call 777-7777. There's no need to call all over town when one call to 777-7777 will get you 30-minute emergency plumbing, air conditioning, and electrical service from Crown, the fastest service in town.
Hey, all right, big brother, you made it. You got a Toyota 4x4?
Oh, so excited!
It's time for you to get excited with Toyota, because the dealing on tough Toyota trucks is exciting. With factory incentives and option savings on 4x4s, and factory-to-dealer incentives on 4x2s.
Oh, yeah!
Plus, see Toyota's exciting new big truck, the Toyota T100. So get excited and get to your Toyota dealer now!
Okay, here's the deal. Valentine's Day's coming up, and you're gonna get your honey a present, right? Well, this gold heart is the perfect gift. Look at that. Isn't it pretty? They're available in stores all over the Houston area or from your favorite bartender. They cost only $2, and here's why they're the perfect gift. You see, all proceeds benefit Variety Club's Charities for Children. Show you care about disabled and disadvantaged children. Buy a gold heart for your sweetheart. Pick one up for yourself, too.
Everybody's got value menus. What's better about Wendy's 99-cent super value menu?
Better food.
Right, quality.
How about the chili?
Right, Wendy's rich and meaty chili. And you, sir?
Lots of choices.
Variety and?
A junior bacon cheeseburger.
Chili.
Right, that chili. How about those salads?
Y'all really fresh.
Oh. Like a Caesar side salad.
And only 99 cents each. And you, sir?
Really great fries.
Ah, yes, biggie fries.
Did someone say chili?
I believe so. Do I know you?
With Wendy's 99-cent super value menu, you don't pay more. You just get more every day.
Texas Governor Ann Richards had dinner with the president tonight.
She, along with the rest of the nation's governors, they're holding their winter meeting in D.C. Governors indicate health care is a major concern for them. And earlier in the day, Clinton watched the Super Bowl with the politically correct governors of New York and Texas. And since Dallas won, Richards has won, too, a bet. New York Governor Mario Cuomo will now fork over 1,000 buffalo wings.
In Nightfile, a desperate rescue effort goes on in Kenya. A train has derailed, killing 140 people. Five cars are still underwater after the passenger train plunged into a river. Floodwaters had weakened a bridge, and it collapsed as the train rolled across.
A brutal kidnapping in Florida. Two children are dead, their mother battling for her life. Gunmen abducted the family, shot the girls, and then repeatedly raped their mother. She was also shot three times but survived. Authorities questioning three men now. A plant explosion in North Dakota has forced the evacuation of 500 to 600 people. Only one person was hurt. Five tanks filled with propane caught fire. The blaze lit up the night sky for 25 miles. 135,000 gallons of propane fueled that blaze.
Coast Guard has seized an arsenal of weapons from a small fishing boat. Five men are under arrest, suspected of running arms to Cuba. Their boat was stopped 180 miles from Miami.
And finally, not everyone was watching the big game today. In protest, a group of Philadelphia football widows held their own Super Bowl of Beauty. We don't name them, we just report them. Ooh. The women got designer do's and don'ts, all this to even the score with their remote-controlled, beer-drinking, chip-eating, couch-potatoed, pigskin-pacified husbands.
Anyone in particular there?
No.
Got that off her chest. Any day's a good day to watch football. No complaints here today, weather-wise, anyway.
Ted up next to let us know if this super weather will continue.
When cars are called luxury sedans, what does that mean? Leather appointments? Absolutely. Dual airbags, wood trim? Mandatory. Gotta have a CD player and power sunroof. But on most luxury sedans, these features cost extra. Not the Infiniti J30. They're all standard. See, Infiniti thinks when you buy a luxury car, the luxury shouldn't be optional.
To lease a fully equipped J30 for just $399 a month, see your Infiniti dealer now.
There's something special about the pharmacist at Randall's. From their knowledge of medicines and prescriptions to their accurate record keeping, you can count on Randall's to fill all your needs. Take advantage of once-a-year specials during drugstore days at Randall's, where you can save now on all your health and beauty care needs. Save this week on Tylenol Extra Strength Tablets, 100 count, just $5.99. Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold Medicine, 36 count, only $3.99. And our entire line of Clarion Cosmetics, 25% off.
The other day I get in my car, won't start. No small problem, right? Well, I figure it's the battery, so I go down to the AutoZone and I tell them what I need. The guy says to me, let's check your old one first. It might not be the problem. Turns out he was right. All I needed was a new battery cable. Talk about saving money. Now you tell me, would another parts store done that? They made sure I got exactly what I needed. Now I'll remember that. Believe me, I will.
Test drive looks pretty much like another, huh?
When you test drive the luxurious 93 Nissan Maxima, you'll find every exceptional feature you ever dreamed of, including an exceptional value. Maybe that's why it's been acclaimed by car magazines and owners alike. Now get a Maxima GXE for $279. Just get to your Nissan dealer this weekend. Nissan, it's time to expect more from a car.
Well, you can expect to hear an earful about America's team for the next year.
Just what we want to hear. Craig Roberts has a preview of Sports Sunday now.
Hi, Larry. Hi, Sharon Min. Hello again, everybody. Well, at least it was a close game. Yes, the Cowboys complete their rebuilding in a super way. We'll have reports on the game, of course. Spencer Tillman swapped places with me. He's now out in California, and we'll report to us live from the Rose Bowl, and we'll help you catch up on everything you missed while you were watching the Cowboys beat up the Bills. That's coming up in a little while.
We'll look for you, Craig. Thank you, sir.
Well, close game, huh?
Yeah, well, if you gave us a point spread like that for the forecast.
It was kind of like we had a close forecast for this weekend. If somebody was saying, reminded me at church this morning, said, hey, where's the 90% chance for rain? Well, I don't know where it went this weekend, but it was gorgeous weather for just about anything you might have wanted to do outside, maybe not including this. Hang gliding in Houston? Yes, sir, and yes, ma'am. I understand they've built a little hill somewhere out around I-10 and 610, and yes, they're hang gliding out there. I even saw some hot air balloons to the north and northwest of the city early this morning, so to each his own, lots of things to do and enjoy around the city this weekend. Well, all that's going to pretty quickly come to an end. Not too bad tonight. Partly cloudy, few high thin clouds, and cool once again. That's the forecast. But you can see the clouds really beginning to take over all but northern parts of the state. And wouldn't you know it, then not even a cloud cover will really settle in to pale things up there in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, at least not until tomorrow. We're still under the impression of high pressure, but it's well to the south of us. And as it weakens and begins to move off, we're going to begin to get a few showers in western and even central parts of the state tomorrow. Temperatures are mild, mostly in the 50s, few 40s, even a couple of 30s out in West Texas. The cooler air, though, back through Colorado and New Mexico, and it looks as though they could get snow, especially heavy in southwestern Colorado tomorrow. We got up to 67 degrees here this morning, 37 the overnight low. We're still seeing 50s across the city, 55 down on the island. Humidity high, no measurable wind. Barometer still high and is holding steady. Forecast for tomorrow, becoming mostly cloudy, could even get a rain shower or two late in the day tomorrow. And yes, I did put a blue star on the map here and there to signify those old Dallas Cowboys. They certainly do have a lot to brag about these days up in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. They won't be bragging too much about the weather tomorrow. It will be mild, at least in the northern parts of the state early in the day, but with encroaching clouds, scattered showers in central and south central Texas by Monday midday, and as I mentioned, snow showers in New Mexico, heavier snows tomorrow in Colorado. Now, here's the rather damp forecast for the week ahead. I doubt that we'll see any rain tomorrow, at least before tomorrow evening, after an overnight low of 42, a high tomorrow of about 64, but then an increasing chance for showers, maybe even a thunder shower or so by along about Wednesday. Won't be terribly cold. We'll see highs in the 60s, lows in the 40s, but I do hope you enjoyed this weekend because that's the last of the good weather for a while.
That's it.
That's it.
Oh, we even got Dallas in the forecast there, so let's get them out of there. Tired of that. Broadway Bound is the Mardi Gras theme this year.
And what a really big show it is in Galveston. Next, we'll show you some folks who are already having a ball.
It has a dual overhead camshaft design. 4 valves per cylinder, and a responsive double wishbone suspension. The Acura Integra, an idea that began with a Formula One race car and has been evolving ever since.
Five years ago, a big celebrity came to Lake Edna. KFC is commemorating that day with the amazing Founders Feast. For a limited time, buy 2 pieces of original recipe chicken, mashed potatoes with gravy, coleslaw, and a biscuit. A complete meal, just $2.99. And get a slice of apple pie and a Pepsi absolutely free. The KFC Founders Feast, just $2.99. A feast fit for a king or a colonel.
We do chicken right.
Says there are no heroes. What about the guy who treats a fender like modern art? And all the ones who never call the game on account of weather? There are people who make things perfect 1,000 times a day. And if Bank of America can help with the money, keep things safe, save them some time, then they can go on doing the really important things. Banking on America. Bank of America.
Why did you buy a Ford truck?
Well, because it's Texas tough. I've got enough going on without having to worry about my truck. And that's why I bought the most problem-free full-size pickup made. I guess that explains why Ford can say they have more repeat buyers, too.
Why did you buy a Ford truck?
Because nobody backs you better after the sale. Only Ford stands behind their pickups with emergency road service and a toll-free number to call for assistance. I'll probably never need it. But it's good to know I have it.
They're already having a ball in Galveston.
Yeah, some early Mardi Gras festivities underway this weekend. Broadway Bound is the theme this year. Hundreds are dressed in their Mardi Gras best for the Crew of Aquarius mask ball and royal pageant. All kinds of costumes, dancing, a king and a queen out there. Across town, it's the 4th annual LULAC Mardi Gras Scholarship Ball. They also crowned a queen here. The winner there is a candidate who raises the most money for scholarships. Pretty good idea. The queens will ride atop floats at the Crew of Brew Parade. Now that's the 13th of February at 6:30. We'll broadcast that parade live right here on Channel 2. Well, you ready to get this Dallas heavy evening over with?
Sure.
Let's end it.
America's Team and Craig's Show coming up next.
Good night.
Is Channel 2's Sports Sunday.
Hi again, everybody. Remember a couple of weeks ago we told you the Cowboys beating the Niners was the Super Bowl? It was. Today they were just selling some extra T-shirts. As for the day itself, it was perfect in Southern California. Temperature in the mid-60s, no rain. The Bills won the coin toss and then lost everything else. At halftime, it was Dallas 28-10. Buffalo couldn't do to Dallas what they did to Houston. Could they? Nope, not even close. Dallas took advantage of 9 turnovers, and it's won its first Super Bowl under the Jones-Johnson regime, 52-17. Thurman Thomas from the three, Bills led 7-0 after a blocked punt, the first turnover going Buffalo's way. But after that, it was all Dallas. Cowboys get their first of 9 turnovers. James Washington, the interception of Jim Kelly.
At the 44-yard.
And then it was Troy Aikman's turn to go to work, and go to work he did. Aikman to Novacek, 7-7. As it turned out, Aikman would be the most valuable player. I thought Novacek would be a big key in the game. 2 plays later, Charles Haley strips the ball. Jimmy Jones recovers, touchdown, and it's 14-7. Second quarter, Ken Norton hits Kelly. The right knee, if you watch the game, it was ugly. There's no doubt that he's through. Just completely came out. That's the same injury he had against the Oilers, and Frank Reich was back in. Steve Christie with a field goal. It's still close, 14-10, couple of minutes to go before halftime. Marv Levy is thinking if we can hold on here, we'll regroup, get Reich some extra time, but didn't happen that way. Aikman to Michael Irvin from 19 yards out, 21-10. Then it was Aikman to Irvin again after another turnover, 18 yards, and bingo, it's 28-10 at the half. Now, Reich did manage to throw a touchdown, albeit he was over the line of scrimmage probably when he threw it. There wasn't much doubt about that one. To Don Beebe, that made it 31-17, and you're thinking, well, maybe. I'm sorry, not this time. They just poured it on in the fourth. Lights out, fourth touchdown throw. This one, again, going Dallas's way. Alvin Harper makes it 38-17, and you figured, well, surely they're through. No, they're not. Emmett Smith, who was, again, over 100 yards, and what a season. Well, what a last couple of great seasons he's had. And then the final one for the final margin of 35 on yet another turnover, it was Ken Norton Jr., the linebacker, who finally got the handle and ran it in. And again, the final 52-17, Dallas winning their third Super Bowl, the sixth time they have made the trip. Again, their first one, though, under that new regime up there, who only took 3 years to turn things around. Words always flow after a Super Bowl, and why not? There were 3,000 credentials issued to reporters of all types. Some of the post game went this way.
All I can say is that I know how much this game meant to me and how devastated and disappointed I would have been had we not have been able to win. And Jim's been here 3 times and hasn't been able to walk away with a victory. And, I really don't know what to say about it. I really hope that I wish every quarterback could come to the Super Bowl and walk away from this thing as a winner. And I'm very fortunate that I've been able to do it my first time.
I don't mind winning another, but I'm telling y'all now, I'm a happy man. I have done all that I want to do in life. If I leave here tonight, believe me, I leave with my life complete.
Troy, I personally don't think he did anything exceptional today. He went out there and was Troy. That's the way he plays. He's always a great player, and he's going to go out there and prepare himself in the right way and go out there and want to win, and that's what he did.
I'm disappointed. We got beat. We got beat the way we did. I know we're a lot better football team than we showed today, and the biggest disappointment, you worked so hard during a 16-game schedule, 4 exhibition games, postseason, playing the games we have, and then lose the way we did today, and it's all of a sudden, hey, we got to start from scratch next year, and heck, this is a business, this is our job, this is something I enjoy doing, and hey, we got to start from ground zero again.
That, of course, Jim Kelly, the first guy you heard from, Troy Aikman, again, being the most valuable player in this game, and the little town of Henrietta, Oklahoma, just agog tonight, all 5,500 residents watching their hero, Troy Aikman, beat up the Bills. Former Willow Ridge High School star Thurman Thomas of Missouri City has been in the spotlight all 5 years he's been in the leagues, been the league's most valuable player. Bardenas visited with some of his family tonight, those not having made the trip to Southern California.
One place in Houston where the Super Bowl really had some meaning was at the home of Preston Thomas, uncle of the Buffalo Bills running back. He was joined by Thurman's grandmother, aunts, nieces, nephews, and family friends.
Does this make the game kind of hard for you to enjoy?
Yes, indeed it does, because you've seen it twice, and you don't know what to expect. And here in Texas, everybody's talking about Dallas, and it's got me all upset, you know. So we're We're just trying to hold on real tight.
When he was growing up, I knew he liked, you know, sports, but I never thought that he would go on to be in the NFL. And when he did, I just, well, you never know.
These people have been the driving force in what Thomas has accomplished since being a star at Willow Ridge High in the early 1980s. But they've also learned, along with him, that being a star in the NFL can also mean some bad press, of which Thomas has had his share.
Buffalo Bills, the towel over the helmet of number 34, Thurman Thomas. He's not going to forget Super Bowl 27.
I just told him, just be himself. And some things he say, I said, just don't open your mouth and say them. Just, you know, let him alone. So I think he'll learn that.
Preston Thomas had six TVs going in his home today, and of course, the house exploded every time Thurman or the Bills did anything right. So early in the game, there was a lot of this. And when Thomas scored the Bills' first touchdown, well, get out of the way. Plenty of reason for grandmother to boast. And even though things went downhill for Thomas and his teammates after that, Thurman will have plenty of support when he comes home to try to regroup after that third straight defeat. Hey, that's what family's for. Bart Ennis for Sports Sunday.
Thank you very much, Bart. While up in Irving, the home of the Cowboys, Texas Stadium was open for fans not staying at home in the Metroplex or making the trip to Pasadena, but a funny thing happened. Hardly anyone at all bothered to turn up there, so the rest of them went out into the streets to party, and you saw some of that off the top of the program. I guess Dallas just doesn't like going to Texas Stadium, that place with a hole in the roof, when the Cowboys aren't actually in there, and I can't say that I blame them. One of the reasons perhaps they were turned off, the Cowboys said they'd let them in for nothing, but they were going to charge them for the beer and the hot dogs. Apparently, the bars had discounts for Cowboy fans, so they loved their football, but they also loved their discount drinks in the Metroplex. This morning, MTV had its Super Bowl show live from the Rose Bowl some 6 hours before kickoff, and one of the guests was Haywood Jeffries of the Oilers. MTV did spell his last name wrong, but they did let super interviewer Bill Murray ask the tough question.
Can I ask you a question? What's it like to get a concussion? That's something I always wanted to know.
Well, it's not a good feeling. It's like a lineman eating a lot of food and you're throwing up.
Oh, great. Thanks very much.
Haywood also showed off his watch. As you can see, it was a subtle little piece of jewelry there. He, I think, uses that in the front of the car if the lights don't work. Every year on Sports Sunday, we update you on things you may have missed if you were watching the Super Bowl, and this year is no exception.